Back to the weather and day five of our heat wave, especially dangerous for those of you out there, thousands of you who do not have air conditioning. WLWT News 5's Brian Hamrick joining us live tonight with how hot it is getting inside some homes out there. Brian?
Yeah, Mike, I want to show you something. This is a device that measures the heat surface temperature, sends out a beam, it comes back. Let me show you. The bricks on this wall, for example, 93 degrees. If I put it on the sidewalk, it tells me it's 92 down there. Problem is, when folks go inside these buildings, it's not much different.
The only reason Andrea Ray and her three kids are outside in heat like this,
it's hot. It's burning up hot.
Is because the temperatures inside your apartment are even worse.
You should go straight upstairs, it's burning up. Like, even if you open up windows, it's blowing in hot air.
Like many with no air conditioning, escaping the hot weather would take a feat that would impress Houdini, especially in the upper floors. We took a look at the surface temperatures in some of those un-air-conditioned buildings.
Down here on the first floor, we're getting readings of 79, but look what happens when we go up.
Two floors above, surface temperatures in the high 80s.
And by the time you get to the top floor, we can tell a noticeable difference, and we're getting readings here of 109.
I'm on the second and third floor.
In Carlisa Cruz's shade-drawn home, almost everything reads out over 80 degrees.
85 degrees Fahrenheit.
Temperatures on the outside wall in the high 80s, and on the windowsill, close to 100.
It's killer. It's killer. It's not good, but we don't have to make it do.
And for those with no AC, there's no lowering the temperature without a cold front.